Hey everybody, today's little segment's going to be about balancing your heating vents and how to get your home much more comfortable. And there's some logic behind this, and a lot of people don't realize one side of your house can be cold, one side can be warm, the middle can be warm, the other side cold, vice versa. And this little segment's on how to make your house much more comfortable for you and your family and get the most out of your HVAC system. Virtually all the homes here up in the Northeast that are forced air have systems like these where you have vents in the rooms, and they're basically the discharge vents for the air. And like this one here, there's no adjustment in the room to adjust if there's too much or too little. And of course, likewise, in the bathroom here, we have another vent that has no adjustment to it on the main floor. And in the office here, it's the same circumstances where there's no adjustment. So, like all these homes with these forced air systems, you got to supply air here and a return air into the system. It either heats it or cools it depending on what mode you have. And you can see in this house, it's installed on one side of the house, and the ductwork extends all the way to the other side. So this main trunk line. So first it comes out of the furnace, goes into the plenum, and then goes up into the main trunk line that feeds the rest of the house here. And off of that, you'll have branch lines and that come across and feed the registers inside each room. And of course, in the center, these return air ducts bring the air back because obviously, when you put hot air into the room, well, obviously the air has somewhere to go, so you have to bring that cold air back into the room, say in the heating season. So the best way to even out the temperature in the house is there's dampers and they're little control valves, and obviously there's reflectix on this and it's covering it up. There's a round ductwork that goes through here, and these handles here adjust a valve inside which allows more air or less air into the house. And if you look at the edge here, the way this is set, you can actually see which angle the damper is set. So obviously the damper is this way, it's partially open. And if I wanted to feed more into this room, depending if it was upstairs or downstairs, I can open or close that. So to begin with this, the first thing you want to do is open every single vent in your entire house. And if you have like an adjustment upstairs, make sure they're all open. And downstairs here, make sure these are all open. And then at that point, let your heating system or cooling system heat or cool your house, and then go into each room and just feel the temperature. And basically, okay, obviously this is opened all the way now. It's coming and flowing at full. So I open all of them up and allow it to go full into the room, and then I check the temperatures from that point. And now that they're all open, I give it some time, a couple hours, maybe even a day. And then come back the next day and see if a room is too hot compared to the rest. Obviously it's getting too much. You may just want to throttle that one back. So obviously this is going to close it off, and this gives it half the amount, and you adjust them a little bit at a time for each room until you balance the temperature out. Now you don't want to close them all up because the air has nowhere to go. Sometimes on a two-story, you may need to push more air upstairs and throttle back the lower floors to get the air to the upstairs floors. So you can imagine that, let's say it's the heating season and the furnace kicks on and now it's starting to blow air and it travels down the main trunk line. And obviously, right where it comes out, the first ones are going to get the most amount of air. And typically, that may put way too much heat to this section of the house where I need it much farther down. I may have to throttle it back slightly here. And each house is going to be different on the setup. So when you get your ductwork dialed in and all the rooms and the temperature in each room is pretty much even, what you want to do is
go ahead and take a black magic marker and just put a little line right here. And like right now, this would be set for winter, I'd put a W. And the difference between the winter and the summer would be different, because say you have a two-story home, you're going to need much more cooling upstairs. So when summer comes along, you may have to just tweak this slightly. The only way to get around that would be to zone out your house, which is quite expensive. But this is the easiest, cheapest way to get your house much more comfortable. It helps save and balances out your home. If you have any questions, comments, thoughts, or ideas, please feel free to place a comment in there. And please subscribe. I appreciate everybody watching this. And thank you very much.